base pump for him. He's safe.
Play ball. That hit him. He's got first. Ball four, take the base. Three, ball four, take your base.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Pinch hitting for
three.
Number 41. Yeah. And you.
Pinch the ball
four. Your attention please.
Three. Ball four. Pinch the
now playing center. Number 58.
Ball four. Pinch the base.
He's running at third.
He's safe.
Number 62.
Pinch the base. Ball four.
Garcia. Now pitching for the Blue Jays, number 54, Roberto.
First base.
Three.
Oh,
he's safe. Three. Let's play ball. Ball four, take your base. That hit him. First base. Three.
Your attention, please. He's running at first for the Yankees. Number 58. Up next, guys, the center fielder, Miguel.
Three!
And he has a defensive change for the Yankees. Now playing center field. Number 30, Greg Allen.
Welcome, everyone. Let's jump right in and revisit the news and events from Monday.
Looking first at the American League East, the Expos allowed only 5 hits in the game as they beat the O's in Baltimore 3-1. At the start of the day,
play ball. Ball four, take the base. ball. Take your base. Out. Three. Ball four, take your base. Ball four, take your base.
Now back. Number 20.
Take your base, ball four. Let's play ball. Take your base, ball four. Three. Ball four, take your base. Three. 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 Ball four, take your base. He's out. Ball four, take the base. Ball four, take the base. Take the base, ball four.
Hello there, baseball fans. Let's recap what went down around the league on Wednesday.
Looking first at the American League East,
Keone Kella got his sixth win of the year out of the bullpen, leading the Blue Jays to a win over the Red Sox, 4-3.
As of right now,
the Red Sox are in third place in the AL East,
but they currently hold a spot in the AL wildcard race, while the Blue Jays are second in the division.
They trail first by four games.
The Baltimore Orioles tossed a combined one hitter as they got the best of the Expos.
Play ball. Three. Ball four, take the base. Ball four, take the base. Three. Take your base, ball four. Ball four, take your base. Three. 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 Ball four, take your base. Take your base, ball four. Ball four, take your base.
Happy Friday, baseball fans. Welcome to Inside the Show.
Starting in the AL East, the Boston Red Sox knocked out 12 hits as a team
as they took down the visiting Blue Jays 8-5.
As of today,
the Red Sox sit in third place in the American League East Division,
yet they currently hold a spot in the race for the American League wild card. And the Blue Jays are second in the division,
five games back.
The Expos put up 16 hits on the day as they blew out Baltimore 13-2. Entering the day's action, the Orioles are in last place in the AL East. They're over...
Let's play ball. Take your base, ball four. Ball four, take your base. Ball four, take your base. Three. Take your base, ball four. Three. Ball four, take your base. Three.
Take your base, ball four.
Three.
Ball four, take your base.
Great Sunday action lies ahead, but first, here's what happened in the major leagues on Saturday. Starting in the AL East, the Toronto Blue Jays totaled 13 hits as a team as they beat the Tribe in Cleveland 9-4. In the standings, the Indians sit in second place in the AL Central Division 13 games out, while the Blue Jays sit in second place in the American League East Division.
Let's play ball.
The regular season is winding down, but the postseason races are heating up. Here's how yesterday's nail-biting action went down.
Looking first at the American League East, the Blue Jays launched three home runs as they got the extra inning victory against the Indians, 8-6. Heading into the day, the Indians are in second place in the AL Central, 14 games back. And the Blue Jays are in second place in the AL East, 3 games back. The Expos combined to give up just 5 hits as they took down the Yankees in the Bronx 3-0. As of today, the Yankees have now clinched the AL East division and a postseason berth. They will be playing in October. The Boston Red Sox sent 3 balls into the seats as they took down the visiting Orioles 6-2. At the start of the day, the Red Sox are in third place in the AL East, 8 games out of first. And the Orioles are at the bottom of the division. They're over 20 games out of first. The White Sox finished off a 3-game sweep as they took down the Tigers in Detroit 6-3. As of right now, the Tigers are in fourth place in the AL Central, 17 games out of first. This season, leading Minnesota past the Royals 3-1. Heading into the day, the Royals are in third place in the AL Central, 16 games out of first. While the Twins are at the bottom of the division, they're over 20 games out of first. The Oakland Athletics had 12 hits as a team as they pulled off the win against the Angels in Orange County 7-4. In the standings, the Angels have now clinched the AL West division and a postseason berth. They will be playing in October, while the Athletics are second in the division, 1 game out of first. The Seattle Mariners racked up 11 hits as a team as they bested the Beavers 10-8. Entering the day's action, the Beavers are in last place in the AL West, 14 games back. And the Mariners are fourth in the division, 8 games out of first. The Atlanta Braves hit 3 long balls as they got the home victory against the Astros 5-2. As of right now, the Braves are in second place in the NL East, 9 games back, while the Astros sit in third place in the American League West division, 3 games back. The Lions combined for 10 hits as a team as they got the best of the visiting Mets 4-3. At the start of the day, the Lions have now clinched the NL East division and a postseason berth. They will be playing in October, and the Mets are third in the division, 11 games out of first. Trey Turner totaled 4 hits overall on the day as the Nationals disposed of the Phillies 2-0. He is currently among the doubles leaders in the National League. Heading into the day, the Nationals are in fourth place in the NL East, 12 games behind first place. And the Phillies are at the bottom of the division, 20 games out of first. The Cardinals got 11 hits overall as they secured the win in extra innings against the Cubs, 5-4. In the standings, the Cubs sit in second place in the National League Central, 18 games out of first. And the Cardinals are at the bottom of the division. They're over 20 games out of first. The Reds grabbed 13 hits in the game as they defeated the Pirates at PNC Park, 9-3. As of today, the Pirates are in fourth place in the NL Central. They're over 20 games out of first. While the Reds have now clinched the NL Central division and a postseason berth, they will be playing in October. The D-backs knocked out 10 hits as a team as they toppled the Rockies 9-2. Entering the day's action, the Rockies sit in last place in the National League West division. They're over 20 games out of first. And the Diamondbacks are fourth in the division, 19 games out of first. The San Diego Padres pitched well, allowing only 3 hits, as they got the best of the Dodgers at home 3-1. Heading into the day, the Padres sit in second place in the National League West division, but they currently hold a spot in the NL wildcard race. And the Dodgers have now clinched the NL West division and a postseason berth. They will be playing in October. The San Francisco Giants put up 16 hits on the day as they got the best of the Brewers at home 7-3. At the start of the day, the Giants have now clinched one of 2 NL wildcard spots with the win. And the Brewers are in second place in the NL Central, 18 games out of first. That'll do it for now. Enjoy today's Pennant Chase Baseball, and don't forget to check back in tomorrow morning for all the highlights from the action.